Okay, so this is the third video, and I'm going to be covering the dress and her clothing, and I'll be using chipped sapphire and pumice stone on this one. So I'm going to start with the brush end of the chipped sapphire, and I'm going to be working in small areas because it's quite a bold colour. So that I can blend it out. And I'm using my 00 brush, which I'm just going to slowly blend it out. Just want to very lightly pull that colour up a bit, but keep the top fairly light. And this is like the skin tones, this is just my base coat, so I want to get a bit of colour over everything, but a very soft colour, and then I'll come in and add the definition on the next round. Again, working in smaller sections. And this bit here as well. And then just pulling the colour out. Just take some of that off. Yep. So it's all soft lines at the moment, and the only harsh lines are actually where the folds of the dress are. So we're going to do the other side. I'm going to have to flip her up, otherwise I won't be able to get my pen to go around. And I'm just using a very small little delicate brush stroke, so as I don't get a big splodgy line. It is easier to control the amount of ink you have with your smallest brush than it is with the marker pen, but it is more convenient to have the marker pen than inks, for me personally. There we go, and we'll just put the colour on her shoes as well. Okay, and just blend it out. Okay, so while all of the blue is just drying out a bit more, I'm going to put the pumice stone on to highlight the darkest points on her gloves. I quite like making the dark areas on a white glove really, really dark. And then if you put stickles, which is what I had on the tilde I showed you at the start of these three or these videos, it looks quite nice. Well, I think it looks quite nice anyway. I'm just going to use the brush end there. As I'm going for more of a pronounced dark line, I'm not too worried about doing lots of areas at once in the pumice stone. I'm not looking for it to be massively soft apart from on this bit of the dress. Actually, on the gloves, I want it to be quite a distinctive line. I'll just give it a very light smudge out. There we go. And then we'll just catch her socks as well. Like that a bit more up here. I'm just going to pick out her tiara, which is also covered in stickles, so I'm just going to pull that colour along a little bit up there. So I blend the edge out, but it won't really matter too much when the glitter glue goes on top. Okay, so now to pick out all of the detail on her dress using the chipped sapphire fine point. There. Right, that's highlighted all the colours that need that. I'm just going to do a very light blend on all of that. I want it to stay quite bold. All of her clothes, and that we're at the end of doing all the clothes and the outfit. Okay.